Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Let's get on to PIB dated 3rd of December 2019. The first press release was about Pradhan Mantri Swasthya Suraksha Yojana. So it's just a factual information we have to keep a track on. First of all, it's a central sector scheme and that too was approved way back in the year 2006. So it is not something new, but it has resurfaced, so let's just cover it. So basically it is about Swasthya. Swasthya we know is a health, so it definitely is trying to correct the imbalances in the availability of affordable healthcare facilities, because we know we have good infrastructure when it comes to healthcare facilities in big hospitals in metropolitan cities only, and not in the maybe little less than the metropolitan cities. So this is what this scheme is trying to achieve, correcting the imbalances in the affordable healthcare facility. So in one phase it would set up new aims, and in the second phase it would try upgrading the existing central sector government medical college institutions, etc. So we know in every budget, maybe not in every, but in maybe last to last year, we just had this news that government is planning to set up new aims. So that was under this very scheme, Pradhan Mantri Swasthya Suraksha Yojana. Alright, just two three things are important, the purpose, and basically it's a central sector scheme. This is important point, and the approved way back in the year 2006. Alright. Second was about the rotavirus vaccine. I'm sure we already know what this is. Basically, this is to prevent the diarrhea, and name is Rotavac 5D. Important thing is it has been developed indigenously by Bharat Biotech. This is it. Rotavirus as such is important, and also one thing that I have come across while searching for this very news is that in The Hindu, it has been categorically stated that this diarrhea rotavirus cannot be prevented by maintaining the basic hygiene. I mean, this is not the statement in The Hindu. What they have written is that rotavirus can only be prevented using the vaccine itself, while diarrhea caused by rotavirus can only be prevented by this very vaccine and not by maintaining the basic hygiene, as is the case with other diarrhea. But in one of the research paper, it has been written that by maintaining basic hygiene also, this rotavirus caused diarrhea can be prevented. So maybe you people too need to search this a bit on your own, although it's not in the PIB, but again I feel it is important. So we just have not any sort of clarity over whether this can be prevented using by maintaining basic hygiene or not. All right so as per PIB, this information was there in the PIB, rotavirus vaccine by Bharat Biotech. That's it. Further, this is important, Mahila Kisan Sashaktikaran Pariyojana. Mahila Kisan Sashaktikaran Pariyojana. Sashaktikaran means empowerment. So this is not by Ministry of Agriculture. This rather is by Department of Rural Development, and we know this department is under Ministry of Rural Development. So just don't get confused by the name of it. Just memorize Mahila Kisan Sashaktikaran Pariyojana, which is to empower women in agriculture, is by the Department of Rural Development, Ministry of Rural Development. Alright. Purpose is either way very very obvious, that is to empower the women Kisan. Because whenever we think of Kisan, I'm sure only one picture comes in our mind, that is of a male person. But this very scheme tries to identify Mahila as a Kisan and try to build on its capacity. Further, you can pause and read the objective and focus and strategy on your own, but any good thing that you can think of would be a part of this very program. So either way, it's very very obvious. What is point that are to be memorized are this. First of all, it's a sub-component of the Deen Dayal Antyodaya Yojana, that is National Rural Livelihood Mission. Further, support to the tune of up to 60% for such projects is provided by Government of India, and for the northeastern state the support shall be to the tune of 90%, and this too is important, and that make it a central sponsored scheme and not a central sector scheme. So definitely whose ministry it is, under which ministry it is, this is important. And basically it's a sub component of National Rural Livelihood Mission and further funding pattern. That's it. Further, this again is something I come across in the PIB. What exactly is iFMS? From the name itself, we really cannot gauge anything. So basically, it's an integrated fertilizer management system. So iFMS is what? It's an integrated fertilizer management system. So definitely it's by Department of Fertilizer under Ministry of Chemical and Fertilizers, and purpose is either way obvious. So it's an IT enabled system wherein government would be keeping a tab on the supply of the fertilizer subsidy. So we'll be dealing with what exactly is a fertilizer subsidy in the very next PIB, but this is it. Basically what IFMS is, this is it. And further, all concerned stakeholders will be able to monitor this very integrated system. Concerned stakeholders are either way obvious, all the agencies that are involved in delivering the fertilizer subsidy. All right. Now this is important. Whenever we're talking about the subsidy in fertilizer sector, we just have to keep in mind that this is not given directly to the farmers. Rather, this is given to the fertilizer companies, who in turn provide the fertilizers to the farmers at a subsidized cost at point of sale machines. I mean, through point of sale machine, of course. So yes. And this is the very reason government has launched this integrated fertilizer management system, because huge subsidies given to the fertilizer company. But we just have to keep in mind that there has to be transparent system in order to monitor how much exactly is the supply of subsidized fertilizer to the farmer, because that is our ultimate objective, and not to just pay the subsidy to the fertilizers company. So this is the very reason government has launched this IT enabled system as well. So for next point is that as of now, 100% direct benefit transfer is there when it comes to the dissemination of the fertilizer subsidy. So DBT 100% is there, and that too across all states and union territories. And further, subsidies mean subsidies to the farmer definitely, but through the companies, fertilizer companies. All right. Next is this, that demand satisfied by contraceptives in India is to the tune of 74.3%. It's just that sometimes we just end up manufacturing some sort of data on our own, and we just end up writing that there is a huge unmet demand of contraceptives in India, and maybe to the tune of some over 50%. So just keep this thing in mind, that this is not a very grim situation. The unmet demand is only to the tune of some 30 to 34%, because already we have satisfied demand up till 74%. So this is it. Don't just end up manufacturing any data. That's it. Further, this is about the criteria that is there in order to get the Ratna status. If any in economic book anybody is reading, I'm sure the criteria is right there in those books, but in PIB also this has resurfaced. But I'm not explaining it here because there is nothing to be explained. It's just 4 or 5 points we just have to memorize. So I have provided the link of this very thing here, and I'll be giving this link in the description box also. Kindly go through it once. I will really not be recommending skipping it. It's good to read it once, because I feel this is important. Maybe not very important, but again, those of us who know this thing, we just think it's not important. But we, if somebody is not into this, then it becomes important. So long story short, just read it once. All right. Further, this was about Parliament passing the Special Protection Group Bill 2019. So I have already covered this very news when it was passed by the Lok Sabha. So either way, I have covered it. It's right there in the playlist. So also, one more thing I would like to say here is that if you are watching this PIB lectures, then I would urge you to watch it from video number 1 till end. There is no point in jumping into any video and watching it, because a question can be asked from any day's PIB. It's good to watch it holistically or not watch it at all, right? So yeah, so I have covered this thing already, so I'm not going to cover it again. So this is it. Further, this is about Parliament passes the Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu merger of union territories bill 2019. So right now we will be seeing that we no longer be having two union territories, rather it shall be merged into one. So this is important. What exactly are changes here is gonna be, this is not important, because either way government has said that there's not gonna be any change in administration per se, but this is basically to have some sort of administrative convenience. Also, these union territory would be under the jurisdiction of Bombay High Court. But maybe what's important is the polity aspect here, because we know that any change, that internal reorganization of the state, if government of India is doing, for example, carving out of a new state or merging to two union territories or two states, then we really don't need to go for a constitutional amendment under Article 368 of the Constitution. Rather, internal reorganization is done through Article 3 of the Constitution, and Article 4 categorically states that this shall be through a simple majority only, and in no way it would be a constitutional amendment under Article 368. So this is it. Further, this too I have covered, but I don't think it's important. Only one thing, just try keeping in mind that Mumbai Central Station of the Indian Railway, I mean, Central Station is definitely of railways only, but Mumbai Central Station has become the first station in India to be given this very tag, that is Eat Right Station, and this is given by the Indian Railways. So basically, certification is definitely by FSSAI, so let's just read it now. Mumbai Central Station of Indian Railways conferred with Eat Right Station certification with 0-4 stars rating by FSSAI. FSSAI, we know, is the Food Safety and Standards Authority of India. Alright, to help passengers to make a healthy and right food choice, Indian Railways launched a movement, Eat Right Station, which was a part of the Eat Right India movement launched in 2018 by FSSAI. FSSAI, Munals are always call it FSSAI, so this too is imprinted in the brain. Under this movement, Mumbai Central Railway Station is the country's first Eat Right Station as certified by the Food Safety and Standards Authority of India. So this is it. We have covered it, but it's not important, and this is important. So basically, National Action Plan for Drug Demand Reduction is by which ministry? Not by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, but by Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. Please keep this thing in mind. National Action Plan for Drug Demand Reduction is by Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, and its tenure is from 2018 till 2025. And purpose is either way obvious, but let's just read it now. The plan aims at reduction of adverse consequences of drug abuse through multi-pronged strategy. The activities under this very plan, among other things, include awareness generation programs in schools, colleges, universities, workshops, seminars with parents, community-based peer-led interactions, intervention program for vulnerable adolescents and youth in the community, provisioning of treatment facilities, and capacity building of service provider. This is it. Nothing to be explained. It's either way obvious. Only one thing which is slightly confusing, which could have made a confusion, is this only, that under whose, which ministry it is. So we have studied, it is under Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, and this is it. So this is it for the 3rd of December 2019 PIB. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.